Well, it's time now for our In Focus Health Update. Health correspondent Lino Mudu joins us now with some insight into childhood tuberculosis. Lino.
Hello, Vincent. Hello, everyone. The United Nations World Health Organization says an estimated 200 children die every day worldwide from tuberculosis. This is despite the availability of cheaper drugs to prevent and treat the highly infectious condition. Medical experts say infants and young children are as much at risk of developing drug-resistant TB as adults. They are also particularly at risk of developing severe, often fatal forms of TB. The Stop TB Partnership and the WHO say tuberculosis often goes undiagnosed in children from birth to age 15 for reasons such as lack of access to health services. Now joining us from the phone from Geneva, Switzerland, for more on childhood TB is Dr. Mark Grosata-Grzemska, Secretary of the Childhood TB Subgroup with the Stop TB Department of the WHO. Dr. Grzemska, welcome to InFocus.
Hello.
First, let me have your take on why tuberculosis goes undiagnosed among children. What do you see as the most critical factors?
I think there are few factors that we could list. The first would be that we unfortunately do not have a good diagnostic test for children. And the symptoms, especially in young children, are quite unspecific. It's not like the adult that would be coughing and expectorate. Children may just be a little bit more quieter. They may stop playing. They may have unexplained fevers. But what is important is to link the TB in children with the TB in the family. And if we find a family with TB, with an adult diagnosed with TB, is there where we should pay attention to the children in the household.
So would you say then that the children that are in a family where there is an adult with TB are most at risk of developing the disease, or what, is there a specific category of children that are most at risk?
Yeah, that's correct. Children are usually infected in the household by a parent or another family member who has infectious form of tuberculosis, but especially children that are that have vulnerable immune system, either affected by HIV infection, or malnourished children, or those very young babies are most at risk for falling ill or dying from TB.
Now, let's talk about the symptoms, considering it's very important in terms of determining if a child has TB. What are some of the symptoms among children very close to the one that adults develop?
The older children, probably those at the age of 10 and above, would develop what we call an adult form of the disease. So they will be coughing, they will have night sweats, fevers, and these will be so easy to detect. Unfortunately, the very young ones with their symptoms are very unspecific. They may just stop gaining weight, and if you take a malnourished child already, the mother cannot even notice that. Children would also be less playful. They will just be sitting, could be a little bit lethargic. Sometimes if they develop a non-lung form of the disease, their necks may swell. That, you know, you need an observant eye to see it. So that's why it is important to pay attention to the childhood tuberculosis as a family problem, not just this particular child. We treat this as a family problem, and especially paying attention to families that are affected by TB or HIV.
Okay, Dr. Grzemski, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.
And that was Dr. Malgorzata Grzemski. She's Secretary of the Childhood TB Subgroup of the WHO.